Genital warts is way more common than you think. In fact, hundreds of millions of people globally have been diagnosed with genital warts, or they've been positive for HPV, the human papillomavirus, which causes genital warts. That's why in today's video, we'll be talking about genital warts overall, the symptoms of genital warts, how it's diagnosed, and also how it's treated in today's video, Genital Warts Explained. So let's dive in. If you want to be part of my YouTube journey or you want to support my channel, please like and subscribe below. Also, I make these videos for you, so if you have any topics you want me to do a video on, please leave them in the comment section below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if it's a great topic, I'll make that video hopefully as soon as possible. But if it's a bad topic, like how to teach a monkey how to roller skate, I probably won't do that topic. As I discussed a little bit earlier, genital warts is caused by the human papillomavirus, also called HPV. Genital warts is also called by different names, like condyloma acuminata, and also anal genital warts. Genital warts is considered a sexually transmitted disease. And the question is, how do you get HPV that causes genital warts? You get it from being exposed to infected skin or mucous membranes, and this usually occurs through rubbing of the infected skin to the uninfected skin. Fun fact, someone who has HPV that doesn't have any genital warts at all could still give HPV that causes genital warts to another person. When somebody gets infected, HPV usually lies dormant, and this is called the latent phase, where nobody has any signs or symptoms. Then down the line, weeks or months later, some people will have some genital warts, or they may have no warts at all. Another fun fact, genital warts is the most common sexually transmitted disease in the world. And I know that chlamydia and gonorrhea and HIV get a lot of publicity, but genital warts is way more common. Additionally, in the United States, most people who are sexually active will get HPV at some point in their life. How is genital warts diagnosed? Providers like myself are able to look at the classic lesions in the anal genital region and make the diagnosis on the spot. But some providers choose to get a biopsy to confirm the diagnosis, and that's okay as well. But remember, a biopsy is when we take a piece off or the whole thing and send it off to a pathologist to evaluate and confirm that diagnosis. But most of the time, that's not needed at all. Moving on to the symptoms. The incubation period for HPV is around 1 to 8 weeks. Now, what does the incubation period mean? That's the time frame from when somebody gets exposed to the infected partner and they develop symptoms. And that takes around 1 to 8 weeks for somebody to develop genital warts, if they develop any genital warts. Once they pop up, they can increase in size and amount, unfortunately. But the good news is around 30% or a third will spontaneously resolve, but others may persist. Keep in mind that if the warts do go away, it doesn't necessarily mean that the human papillomavirus is gone as well. It could still be in the body and lie dormant. Genital warts can be seen throughout the genital region. For example, on the vulva of females, the penis in males, the pubic region of both males and females. It can be seen on the perineum, which is that space between the genitals and the anus. And it can also be seen on the anus or around the anus. By the way, I'm gonna put some pictures on this video. I'm zooming in so you can't see everything, but viewer discretion is advised. When genital warts pop up, they're papules, also called bumps, and they have this cauliflower appearance or dome-shaped appearance, or sometimes they can look like skin tags. The color of the genital warts can vary person to person. They can be pink, they can be skin-colored, they can be brown, they can be black, and it really varies based on the person's skin type. The size can also range from a few millimeters to several centimeters, which can be scary in a lot of folks. Some warts can be so large that it can cause disfigurement, and that can be a huge psychological toll on these people, and it's so unfortunate, which is why treatment is so important. So what are the risk factors of developing genital warts? Well, number one is being sexually active. People who are sexually active are more prone to getting warts. Also, people who are immunocompromised, so our HIV folks, our cancer folks, people on immunosuppressive therapies, they're at risk. Also, people who smoke are at risk of developing genital warts more commonly. And also, people who are uncircumcised may have a higher risk of getting genital warts. Treatment of genital warts is varied. And to be honest, a lot of people choose to leave them alone because they're not a huge issue, and most of the time they spontaneously resolve. On the other hand, some people want to get them treated as soon as possible, and that's okay too. If someone's trying to get treatment for genital warts, there's two general categories. The first one is patients can go into the clinic and get treatment from a provider, or they can get prescribed a topical basically and apply it at home. When a patient comes into the clinic, there's several different options that a provider can perform to get rid of those genital warts. For example, cryotherapy. This is using liquid nitrogen to freeze the warts off, and it can be used on several different warts at one time. On the other hand, larger warts may require several different treatments in order to fully go away. Next is trichloroacetic acid, also called TCA. This is applied in a clinic on a weekly basis until the wart falls off. This is also a good option. The last more common thing that we do is surgical removal. Basically, we take it off surgically. When it comes to different treatment options that a patient can do at home, one popular topical is called imiquimod, also called aldara. This topical medication is used around 3 times per week until the wart is gone and can be used up to 16 weeks. Another treatment option is podophyllotoxin. This is a topical and an antimitotic drug. It is applied topically, but a little bit different than aldara. Remember that all these treatment regimens can change based on the person, whether they're male or female, whether they're pregnant or non-pregnant, the size of the wart, and also the location of the wart. There are multiple other treatment options for genital warts, but those are 5 of the more common ones. Remember to always consult with your primary care provider to find the best treatment for you. That wraps up today's video on Genital Warts Explained. I hope you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe below. Otherwise, until next time.